Tonight I come to you with mostly just thoughts. What sometimes can feel like very hollow things, not very stout or meaningful. Do you ever feel that way? Do you ever feel like the thoughts in your head are capable of great, great impact, but also nothing at all if you don't find a way? And there's this ticking clock, this concept of mortality, fate, age, closing windows. People coming up right behind you on your heels with maybe more to offer than you. I don't want to lie. If you want to be different, no one else can be you. You're you. I've said before, fingerprint of God, this concept beyond just being some kind of sentient meat doll driven by lusts, needs, hormones, nothing else. No, 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 no. No, no, no. You are capable of so much. Special, and no, I'm not lying. There are things in this life that you do better or differently than anyone else you know, or that are competing with you, or that maybe you're chasing in your dream journals, or conceptually, people that you think are better than you. You are the only you. God made. I have a little saying right here. Trust the you that he made. Trust the you that he made. There is only one you. Even if you don't believe in God per se, there's still only one of you. Unless you really dig down and see all life as identical. I fear I cannot go on that journey with you. I must acknowledge the beauty of deity. I must say, with clear mind and open heart, that there is a God, and he loves you. He made you special and different on purpose. Deception, no lies, no confusion, no oops, I dropped in a strange trait or a thing I didn't mean to. No. I believe that this God made you so incredibly different than everyone around you that it's almost impossible for you to be like others unless you really, really want to be. And it gets dark and hard and kind of lonely out here in these thought forests where you don't really see people anymore. When your own kind, so to speak, have written you off as too strange or maybe even dangerous, you have to simply know in your heart. Starts with conceptualizing, then with belief, then knowing you are different. You are special. Not at every single thing you try. Not at something you want to be, but you're obviously not gifted at. if you are not a brilliant, talented artist, you're like me, heading very swiftly towards 40, that might not be your thing. But maybe like me, you're a little bit crazy, and you're trying anyway. Maybe you're just mad enough to see greatness through that forest full of trees in your way. Maybe you're willing to accept how you were made and what you were made to do, which is to be absolutely you. Special, different. A lot of people have your fetishes, your aches, your sufferings, your insecurities, but not everyone has the gifts you were given, wrapped up in your beautiful, sacred, special DNA. You are you and no one else, and you don't really have an option. So my thought, the one I'm trying to run with as well, is you lean in until you feel those twigs, branches, burrs scratching up your legs, hitting your arms, slapping you in the face like you've done something wrong. And then you lean in some more. You push your legs, made of meat, sure, but strong meat, dense bones. You are made not like a bird, not like some other lovely animal that have their own special things. No, you are made like you. You can push. You can lean in by choice, by concept, by understanding, by presence of will applied to thought. You can break through. You can get up that hill all alone. Maybe physically, all alone. But I am not too far away conceptually. I am on the crest of a nearby hill. Maybe I'm on my knees gasping, weeping, puking, emptying my guts. But I'm almost there. And if I'm not, I'm gonna push till I am. I'm almost there, and I'm gonna push until I get to that top, God willing and body able, as they say in the southern parts sometimes, Lord willing and the creek don't rise, if in parentheses, if the Lord is willing, and if the creek don't rise, to flood me out. And even if it does, I might just be mad enough to try and swim it. Because I am not some machismo-driven madman. I do not want to be a millionaire for fun. I want to feed my family with my own dreams again, as I have already done once before. Just because someone slams a door does not mean that there is not a nearby window open. Consensually open by someone willing to see who will come through. Shake their hand and say, hey, I'm not giving up. I'm not giving up. I'm not giving up. Sacred. If you choose to believe, you are so loved and special. If you choose to believe, let's go. Let's get our stuff together. Let's get our thoughts together. Let's learn some new techniques to keep old anxieties at bay. Let's try to find a way to work around those panic golems that seem to be able to crush us in one swing. Let's fight. Let's fight. Let's fight our way through the forest of doubt, let's say. Let's climb that hill of resistance, let's say. And let's stand in that light. To me, it's a clear sky, moonlight, stars all over the place, making me feel both big and small, seen, heard, created. Meet me there. Good talk.